Hello everyone, in this video I'm going to determine if Crucial Momentum Cache will really increase the performance of my Crucial NVMe SSD drive. I have in my system a Crucial P5 Plus 2TB NVMe drive, and I'm going to perform the tests on this drive before enabling Momentum Cache and then after enabling Momentum Cache, and of course we're going to compare the results to see how much performance, if any, Momentum Cache will give us. I'm starting the tests with launching some games, and here I'm launching Fortnite, and this is a very heavy game, and the Crucial P5 Plus drive was much faster with Momentum Cache enabled as opposed to Momentum Cache disabled. It was 8 seconds faster. The second and last game I'm testing is PUBG, and this is also a heavy game, and here also the drive with Momentum Cache enabled was faster than the drive with Momentum Cache disabled. But the margin was much lower than with Fortnite, so it was faster by only 2 seconds. Now I'm starting the files copy test, and I'm doing the files copy from the same drive to the same drive so that the results will be accurate. And here I'm starting with a large file that is 35 GB, and there's a big surprise. So the drive with Momentum Cache enabled was twice slower than the drive with Momentum Cache disabled, so it copied the 35 GB file in 39 seconds, whereas the drive without Momentum Cache copied the same file in 18 seconds, and it was averaging 1905 MB per second, whereas the drive with Momentum Cache enabled only averaged 897 MB per second. And I repeated this test many times, and I always got the same results. The second file copy test I'm doing is copying photos and videos always from the same drive to the same drive, and this is more of a real-world test. And here the Crucial P5 Plus drive with Momentum Cache enabled was also slower than with Momentum Cache disabled, but it was slower by only 2 seconds, so the drive with Momentum Cache enabled was averaging 833 MB per second, whereas the drive with Momentum Cache disabled was averaging 932 MB per second. The last file copy test I'm doing is copying a large number of small files from the same drive to the same drive, and these small files amount to 12.3 GB. And here also the drive with Momentum Cache enabled was slower than the drive with Momentum Cache disabled. So the drive with Momentum Cache enabled was averaging 140 MB per second, whereas when you disable Momentum Cache, the same drive was averaging 154 MB per second. And this is not a negligible difference. The last test I'm doing is Crystal Diskmark benchmark. And here Crystal Diskmark benchmark showed like opposite results to what I tested in real world tests. So here it was showing that the drive with Momentum Cache enabled was much faster, especially in the write operations, to the drive with Momentum Cache disabled. And these results in Crystal Diskmark benchmark really raise many questions as per their reliability. Now I want to try to make sense of these contradictory results between Crystal Diskmark benchmark that shows that the drive is faster with Momentum Cache enabled, as opposite to the results that I've got with my real-world test that show that the drive is really slower with Momentum Cache enabled. So what I've done here is that also I've done some tests that I didn't include in this video so that this video won't be very long. So these tests were that I copied files from another SSD that I have in my PC that is really very fast, so it's not a bottleneck, to the Crucial P5 Plus also SSD with Momentum Cache enabled, to see if when I've done the test, like reading and writing to the Crucial were affecting the performance of the drive. But no, also the writing on the Crucial with Momentum Cache enabled was really slow, and it was as slow as using the same drive for read and write. So I'm sure that the tests I've done are representative, at least in my opinion, to what the Momentum Cache will do to your Crucial drive. So at the end, I advise you not to enable Momentum Cache on your Crucial drive as per the results that I've got in my tests. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to put them in the comments section below, and I'll be happy to answer all your questions and all your comments. I want to thank you all for watching. If you like this video, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it, and this way you'll not miss my future videos. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.